Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Here are some tips for using your Mac in college. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 750 supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you can read more about the Patreon campaign. Join us and get exclusive content and course discounts. So if you're in college and you have a Mac, you're probably using your Mac for all sorts of things, from taking notes, doing assignments, and doing research. So here are some tips that will make it safer and easier to use your Mac while in college. So in college it's hard to back up your Mac. You're probably using your Mac in student housing and you probably don't have a Time Machine backup. You're probably not connected to your own Wi-Fi network but the school's Wi-Fi network. So doing a regular backup is tough. But what happens if you lose your Mac or it gets stolen or something happens to it? You will lose all your data that's on your Mac. This could be all your class notes, your assignments, everything. So if you can't do a normal backup, the next best thing is to store all your documents in the cloud. So in System Preferences, if you go to your Apple ID, you'll see iCloud here on the left. Make sure you're using iCloud Drive. And under Options, make sure you have Desktop and Documents folders turned on. This means that all your files stored in those two folders will be saved to iCloud. If your Mac goes missing, all you need to do when you get your new Mac is to sign into your iCloud account and all your documents will reappear. Not only that, you can also go to any other computer. Go to iCloud.com, log in, and find all your files there. When you delete files from the documents or desktop folders, then you'll be able to retrieve them at iCloud.com in the deleted file section for 30 days. So it protects you if you accidentally delete something as well. It's not as good as using Time Machine or some online backup service, but it's way, way better than having your files just stored locally on your Mac and having that one point of failure, just one mistake away from losing all of your files. And as a bonus, when you store your files in iCloud, you can also access them on your iPhone or iPad. So you can go on your iPhone to your Files app and in there see the same desktop and documents folders and all your files there. So if you want to review your notes that you saved in a file to iCloud while you're away from your Mac, you can just pull out your iPhone, go in the Files app, and find that file. You can even make changes and work with them using apps like Pages, Numbers, and Keynote on your iPhone just like you can on your Mac. Now you can use the Calendar app to keep track of your schedule as well as meetings, due dates, things like that. So it's easy to create an event in here. You can double click on a date and fill in all the details. But you can also use the plus button here. Just type what you want the event to be called and then at and then a time. And that's enough to get it on your calendar. And then you can make adjustments from there. You can also add your class schedule to this bit by bit. So you can enter something like that. That'll add it here. And then you can simply hold the Option key down and drag it to other days as well. You can also go in here and click on the date there and select Repeat. And then you could say Custom and then here set it to repeat on different days. So you can do Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, every week, frequency weekly, hit OK, and you'll see it repeat like that. And then go into where you want it to stop. So say right here, delete that one and then delete all future events. So now you can see I've quickly and easily added that class from Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at 9 a.m. to my calendar. If I know there's a certain day where a class won't be held, I can just delete that and just say delete only this event. So I could pretty easily, within a few minutes, populate my calendar with my entire class schedule for the semester. Now you probably want to take notes on your Mac and you could use many different apps to do that. Some in the Mac App Store are dedicated to note taking. If you want to use Pages to do it, you could do it there as well. Under Basic, there's a note taking template. You can go into that and you're in outline mode here. So you can automatically take notes in an outline mode. You could also simply go and use a blank Pages document and enter your notes in any way you want. Your Mac also has a Voice Memos app. And you can use this to record a lecture or a class. You could even dictate your own notes in here to yourself. And the great thing is that this will sync over iCloud as well. So you can actually use the Voice Memos app on your iPhone to record and then the recording will show up in Voice Memos on your Mac or vice versa. Now Pages isn't the only app with an outline mode. If you go into Keynote, which you would think is really just for making presentations, you could also do an outline mode in there as well. I'm going to use a basic white theme here and I can switch the view to outline. And then I can enter notes here in the left and tab in and tab out with tab and shift tab. And what this does is it will create slides for the top level here and then items for each of the levels under it. So you end up here with two different slides like this. It takes a little practice to get used to, but you can do that and even switch to light table mode, which shows you your slides on a table like this. So you can basically use these as digital index cards, putting what you want on different slides, moving them around and rearranging them, and that can help you study for tests. Now you probably get a lot of web links for notes and a syllabus for each class. Sometimes you may get these as PDF files and you could save them and have them on your local drive. Other times it might be web pages. A quick search for me turned up the sample syllabus here, and it's a regular web page here. But what if I want to save a copy of it? A handy thing to do is go to File and Export as PDF from Safari. And you can then export this as a PDF file and put it with your class notes. So now you don't have to go to the web to this page to see the syllabus again. From any app that you work in, even if there's no export as PDF function, you could always go to print and then PDF, save as PDF, to save anything as a PDF that can be printed. Now a really cool thing that you could do using both your Mac and your iPhone is to use your iPhone's camera as a scanner. You can do this on your Mac by using this continuity feature. Just control click in any Finder window here and you have import options to be able to take a photo using your iPhone or scan documents using your iPhone. When you scan a document rather than taking a photo, it'll create a smaller file and it'll kind of flatten out the page a bit. So if there are a few pages from a book in the library that you want to get a copy of, you can scan them like this and now you have a PDF of that document and you could save it with your course notes. Now I have two security tips. You should take security very seriously since you'll be carrying your Mac all around the campus and it could easily get lost or stolen. One of the things that you want to do is you want to make sure that in your iCloud settings, so in here under iCloud, you have Find My Mac turned on. Turn that on, and if your Mac gets lost, not only can you find it using, say, your iPhone's Find My app, but you could also do things like disable it. But in addition to that, almost every university has a way for you to register your Mac. You can usually do that on the university's site, and then you could register your Mac's serial number with your school, so if it gets stolen but then recovered by the school, they know how to get it back to you. And finally, one of the things you may want to do is share files with other students. Now, file sharing can be difficult. You have to be on the same network, you have to enable file sharing, there's permissions involved and all of that. But for just sharing simple files, you don't need to do any of that. You could just use AirDrop. Using AirDrop allows you to send a file very easily to somebody else, either with a Mac or an iPhone, and they could save that file. So you could share notes or share an important document from a class that you have with another classmate. You could always send something by AirDrop by simply control clicking on a file and then choosing Share and then AirDrop. And a list of iPhones and Macs that are near you should appear here if they have AirDrop enabled for everybody or for contacts only, but you're one of their contacts. And then you could just send them that file and then they receive it. No need to set up complex file sharing or anything for that. It just works. So if you're using your Mac while in college, I'd love to hear what tips you have for other students as well. Leave them in the comments below. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.